explanation of this lesson. Last lecture we have seen explanation of natural vegetation and wildlife. Okay, so today we will see question answers and some important points. Okay, so some important points to remember about Brazil vegetation. Okay, so Brazil, there are types of forest, and we'll see the list of major types of forest. So there are equatorial forests, tropical grasslands, swampy lands, hot deciduous forests, thorny shrubs, and temperate grasslands. These are the types of major forests found in Brazil. You have to remember, these are important points. Okay. Reason for variation in rainfall in Brazil. Okay, why there is a variation in rainfall in Brazil? Due to its physiography. Types of forest in region where it rains throughout the year. That type of a forest where it rains throughout the year is known as evergreen rainforest of Brazil. Okay. Types of forest in region where it rains during certain season. When it rains during certain season or certain period, that type of vegetation is grasses, short shrubs, thorny vegetation, etc. Largest number of vegetation species are found in Brazil. Okay, in Brazil, largest number of vegetation species is found. Many types of plants, many types of trees. Okay. So largest number of vegetation species are found in Brazil. Which are the types of trees found in Brazil? Paw Brazil, rubber, mahogany, rosewood, and orchids. Rainforests of Brazil, lungs of the world. Rainforests of the Brazil are known as the lungs of the world. Very important point to remember. Rainforests of Brazil are known as lungs of the world. Same way, India vegetation, we will see major types of forest of India: evergreen forests, deciduous forests, thorny shrubs, Himalayan forests, and coastal forests. These are the major types of forest found in India. The leaves of the trees in evergreen forest are broad and green. How is the leaf? The shape of the leaf is broad and it's green. Color is green. Okay. Types of wood of trees found in evergreen forest. Now, how is the wood quality? It's hard, heavy, and durable. So trees having hardwood, which is heavy and durable, examples are mahogany, rosewood, and rubber. Okay. Its quality of wood is having hard and durable, heavy and durable. In regions, the rainfall is between 1000 mm to 2000 mm, that is deciduous forests are found. Okay. Trees found in deciduous forests of India. Which are the trees found in deciduous forests of India? Teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, etc. These are the examples of deciduous forest trees. Regions having less than 500 mm rainfall. So you get thorny shrub like vegetation. Where rainfall is less than 500 millimeter, you'll get a thorny shrub like vegetation. Types of plants found in regions having less than 500 millimeter rainfall. So which are the plants? Catechu, acacia, khejri, cactus, aloe vera, and agave. Swampy areas, estuaries, and lagoons, coastal type of vegetation. Here, where area is swampy, estuaries and lagoons are there. So vegetation is coastal type. Okay. Coastal type of vegetation is called mangroves or sundarbans. Coastal type of vegetation is also known as mangroves or sundarbans. The wood quality of coastal region is oily, light, and durable. How is the quality of the wood? Oily, light, and durable. Now, types of forest in Indian Himalayas according to altitude. Okay. Now, in Indian Himalayas, which types of forest are found? Highest, we will see altitude wise, according to altitude. Highest altitude, seasonally flowering trees. We will find seasonally flowering trees in highest altitude. Okay. On the top. Now, medium altitude, coniferous trees like pine, deodar, fir. Okay, these are the examples of trees like coniferous, pine, deodar, and fir in medium altitude. Now in the foothills, okay? Foothills means base. Here you will find both coniferous and deciduous types of forest. Near the foothills, both coniferous and deciduous types of forest are found. This was the types of forest found in Himalayas according to altitude. Highest altitude, medium altitude, and foothills. Now we will see wildlife of Brazil and India. Okay. First, we will see Brazil wildlife. Swampy areas of the Pantanal. Anacondas are found. Okay. Animals found in Brazil. Which are the animals found in Brazil? Guinea pigs, crocodiles, alligators, monkeys, pumas, leopards, etc. These are the names of the animals found in Brazil. Varieties, fish varieties in seas. So, in the seas of Brazil, swordfish is found. And fish varieties in rivers, pink dolphins and piranhas are found. So there is a varieties of fish in seas also. Seas, there are swordfish and varieties of fishes in river also. In river, you will get pink dolphins and piranhas. Bird varieties include, now different types of birds are there, which includes condors, parrots, and flamingos. A bird which is huge in size and can fly high in the sky, a very huge bird, big in size and can fly high. So that bird's name is condors. Degradation of environment due to why environmental degradation is there? Because of illegal smuggling of wild animals, slash and burn agriculture. We have seen the slash and burn agriculture in the previous lectures, okay? Roca, deforestation, pollution, etc. Because of these factors, there is degradation of environment. India wildlife. Now, we will see the wildlife in India. Animals found in hot and humid forests are elephants, okay? Swampy and marshy lands of Assam will find one horned rhinoceros is found in swampy and marshy lands of Assam. Arid lands, deserted lands, okay, like desert. You will find wild ass and camels. Camels and wild ass are found in arid lands, in deserts, okay. Snow-capped region of Himalayas. Here, snow leopards and yaks are found in the snow-capped regions of Himalayas. Peninsular region, Indian bisons. In peninsular region, Indian bisons, deer, monkeys, and antelopes are found. So the only country in the world where both tigers and lions are found. So it is India. In India, both tigers and lions are found. It's the only country in the world where both tigers and lions are found. Rivers, estuaries, and coastal areas. Here you'll get turtles, crocodiles. excuse me. Rivers, estuaries, and coastal areas, you'll get turtles, crocodiles, and gavials. That is gharial, type of alligator. Okay. There are, we have seen two types of alligators. One was blunt nose and was long nose. Variety of birds in the forest and weathers, pheasants, ducks, variety of birds found in the forest and beautiful birds, okay, in the forest also and in the wetlands of India. Many species of wildlife are on the verge of extinction because of. So there are many species which have about to end or about their species are becoming very less because of poaching, pollution, and rapid deforestation. Okay, rapid deforestation is if trees are cut, if forests are cut, so where wildlife will go, okay? They will also end, okay, because of deforestation, pollution, and poaching. Many species of wildlife are on the verge of extinction. As you all know, forest is the home to many animals. Measures for protection of wildlife and forest in India. Which are the measures? Which are the measures for protection of wildlife and forest in India? Like, government of India have taken many measures. They have taken many projects to save the wildlife, to protect wildlife. So, setting up of national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries, and biosphere reserves. So we will see the textbook questions first. Identify the odd man out. Okay. So forest type of Brazil. A. Thorny bush type vegetation. B. Evergreen forest. C. The Himalayan forest. D. Deciduous forest. So which is odd over here? Okay, which is odd type of forest? So Himalayan forest, because Himalayan forest is not found in Brazil. So the odd man out over here is the Himalayan forest. Which with reference to India, so with reference to India, which forests are found? C. A. Mangrove forest. B. Mediterranean forest. C. Thorny bush type vegetation. D. Equatorial forest. So with reference to India, which is the odd over here? So Mediterranean forest is odd man out over here. With reference to fauna of Brazil. Anaconda. A. Anaconda. B. Tamarin. C. Red panda. D. Lion. So which is odd over here? With reference to fauna of Brazil, red panda is odd man out over here. Fourth question, with reference to flora in India, deodar, A. deodar, B. anjan, C. orchid, D. banyan. So odd man out is orchid. Now we will see textbook questions, answer in brief. Okay. First question is differentiate between the forest types of Brazil and India. You have to write first forest type of Brazil and forest type of India. You have to differentiate the points. Forest type of Brazil. The northern part of Brazil lies in the equatorial region. So the northern part of the Brazil is lying in the equatorial region. It receives ample sunshine. Okay, because it is lying in the equatorial region, it is receiving ample sunshine and heavy rainfall. So dense evergreen forests are seen here. Okay, in Brazil, dense evergreen forests are seen. Now, forest type of India. The location of India is far away from the equator. Okay, so India's location is very far away from the equator. Heavy rainfall occurs only in the Western Ghats and northeastern hilly areas. Okay, heavy rainfall is received in Western Ghats and northeastern hilly areas. So evergreen forests are seen in these regions. Okay. Now, the highland region of Brazil receives low rainfall. So tropical grasslands are seen in this region. Whereas the peninsula region of India receives rainfall between 1000 millimeters to 2000 millimeters. So they are covered by deciduous forest. See, the highland region of Brazil receives low rainfall. Because of low rainfall, tropical grasslands are seen. Whereas the peninsula region is receiving more than or between 1000 mm to 2000 mm. So they are covered with deciduous forest. Third point, as there are no tall and long extending mountains in Brazil, Himalayan type forests are not found here. So we know this point, like Himalayan forests are not found in Brazil. Third point, owing to presence of Himalayas in India, Himalayas present, right? So Himalayan types of forests are found in north and northeast of India that are classified on the basis of Himalayan forests are classified. We have seen in the points to remember, right? High altitude forest, medium altitude, foothills, like this way. Last point, thorny shrubs are found to the northeastern part of Brazilian highlands, which is also considered to be a drought quadrilateral. So your thorny shrubs are found to the northeastern part of Brazil highlands. Okay. And last point of forest type of India, your thorny shrubs are found in India receiving less than 500 millimeter of rainfall. It is majorly found in Gujarat, Rajasthan, and rain shadow regions of the Western Ghats. Okay. In Brazil, thorny shrubs are found in northeastern parts. And in India, thorny shrubs are found in Gujarat, Rajasthan, and rain shadow regions of the Western Ghats. What environmental issues are faced by Brazil and India? Now, environmental problems, we will see. First point, degradation of environment is happening in Brazil due to illegal smuggling of wild animals, slash and burn agriculture, deforestation, pollution, etc. We have discussed these points earlier also. Degradation of environment is happening because of illegal smuggling of wild animals, slash and burn agriculture. What is slash and burn agriculture? A plot of land is cultivated. First, what happens? A piece of land where trees are there, they are burned. Okay. After burning, whatever ashes found is mixed with the soil to increase the fertility of the soil and to kill insects. Okay. And after that, cultivation is done. And when that soil stops producing crops or giving good yield, so what does the farmer do? They leave that land, okay, and move to next piece of land. That is called a slash and burn agriculture. deforestation, cutting down of trees, and pollution, etc. So these are the factors or reasons why there is degradation of environment in Brazil also and India. So these were the factors of Brazil. Due to these problems, many endemic species are on the verge of extinction. Because of these problems, many species are on the verge of extinction. Third, India too faces environmental issues such as poaching, pollution, and the fast spreading deforestation. India also, there are environmental issues such as poaching, pollution, and fast spreading deforestation. The trees are cut rapidly. Fourth point, many species of wildlife are on the verge of extinction in India. Due to environmental issues or due to this deforestation, many species of wildlife are on the verge of extinction in India. Why does the deciduous type vegetation occupy most of India? There is a question, textbook question. Why does the deciduous type vegetation occupy most of India? Answer. First point, vegetation in a region is affected by the climate and rainfall of the region, right? Vegetation is dependent on, or we can see, if the climate of the region and rainfall depends the vegetation. India lies in the tropical zone and it has a monsoon type climate throughout the year. Okay, India is lying in the tropical zone. That's why we have monsoon type climate throughout the year. Third point, also a major portion of India receives seasonal rainfall between 1000 to 2000. Millimeter. So the rainfall in the most parts of India gets seasonal rainfall between 1000 to 2000 mm. Seasonal rainfall during the monsoon. Fourth point, deciduous forests thrive well in this condition, and these forests shed their leaves during the hot and dry summer, so that the water is not lost due to the evaporation. So in such a climate or in such a rainfall, deciduous forests thrive well. And this condition is very favorable for deciduous forests. And these forests shed their leaves during the hot and dry summer. Okay, when it is hot and dry summer, these types of forests shed their leaves, so that water is not lost due to evaporation. Fifth point, teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, etc. are the trees found in deciduous forest of India. These are the examples of deciduous, these are the example of trees found in deciduous forest of India, such as teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, etc. Give geographical reasons. So we will see the question number one. The northern part of Brazil is covered with dense forest. So why the northern part of Brazil is covered with dense forest? Answer. First point, the northern part of Brazil lies in the equatorial region. So the first point is, first reason is, northern part of Brazil is lying in the equatorial region. Second point, equatorial region receives ample sunlight and it rains throughout the year. What is the specialty of the equatorial region? It receives ample sunlight and it rains throughout the year. third point, the average annual temperature is 28 degrees Celsius and rainfall received is above 2000 mm. So the average annual temperature is 28 degrees Celsius and rainfall is above 2000 mm. So the northern part of Brazil is covered with dense and evergreen forest because of these reasons like heavy rainfall and good climate, ample of sunlight. Okay. So because of these reasons, the northern part of Brazil is covered with dense and evergreen forest. Next, give reason, question number two. Vegetation is scarce in the high altitude of the Himalayas. Means vegetation is less, okay? In the high altitude of the Himalayas. Why? You have to give reasons. First point, as the altitude increases, the temperature decreases. When you are moving towards a high altitude, the temperature decreases. Okay, very cold temperature over here. Second point, the climate is very cold in the high altitudes. In Jammu and Kashmir and parts of Himalayas, temperature drops to minus 40 degrees Celsius. Okay, in high altitude, it's very, very cold and temperature drops to minus 40 degrees Celsius. So this region is snow covered for the most part of the year. Throughout the year, this region like Jammu and Kashmir and high altitudes, okay, this is covered with snow throughout the year, most part of the year. Very few species of plant can survive in such extreme conditions. So if the temperature is very cold, it's covered with the snow. So there are few types of species which can survive that cold condition. Okay. Very few species of plants can survive in such extreme conditions. Only seasoning flowering trees are found at higher altitudes. We have seen, okay, in high altitudes, which types of trees are found? Seasonally flowering trees. Okay? Hence, vegetation is scarce in the high altitude of the Himalayas. Because of this cold climate, the vegetation is less in the high altitude of the Himalayas. Next, give reason. A wide variety of insect species is found in Brazil. Many types of insects, a wide variety of insects, okay? They are found in Brazil. Why? Answer. First point, evergreen forests, grasslands, and swampy lands are found in Brazil. So these types of forests are grasslands, evergreen forests, and swampy lands are found in Brazil. Brazil has a hot and humid climate and heavy rainfall, which favors the growth of dense vegetation. Okay, because of its climate, because of its rainfall, heavy rainfall, there is a growth of dense vegetation. Okay, so dense forests, dense trees are found over here. Third point. So regions with such conditions serves as a favorable ground for insects to breed. These are the reasons why insects' life can be seen. Okay, a variety of insects can be seen over here. So regions with such conditions such as a serves as a favorable ground for insects to breeding. Here, insect breedings, these conditions are favorable for insect breedings. Hence, millions of insect varieties are found in Brazil. Okay, because of evergreen forest, heavy rainfall, favorable climatic conditions, many insect species are found over here. There are some questions related to map. Which this is not from the textbook. This is extra question. Which forests are found in western snow-capped region? So Himalayan forests are found in western snow-capped region. On which coast do you mainly find the coastal vegetation? The coastal vegetation is mainly found along the eastern coast. Which type of forest occupy maximum area in India? Why? Deciduous forests are found in a region receiving rainfall between 1000 millimeter to 2000 millimeter. You can see the map. There is an index also. First box, dark colored, you can say brownish color or gray, dark gray color. It indicates evergreen forest. Okay. Then light blue color box indicates for deciduous forest. Dark blue indicates for thorny shrubs, and light gray is for Himalayan forest. And blackish color is for coastal forest. Okay. In the, see carefully in the coastal regions, like in the boundaries, okay, of the India map, you can see the black spot is there. So there is a coastal types of forest found over here. Okay, we will see some extra questions. Suggest measures for the conservation of wildlife and forests in India. So what are the measures for conservation of wildlife and forests? So in India, restricting wildlife trading and hunting. First point is restricting wildlife trading and hunting. Okay. Hunting of wild animals is restricted in India. Second, declaring more national parks and sanctuaries. Okay. Third point is giving more importance to protection of endangered animals. Like projects are taken and some measures are taken by the government to protect animals, endangered animals. So more importance is given to protect endangered animals. Fourth point, controlling felling of trees. Fifth point, implementing afforestation and social forestry. With the help of these measures, conservation of wildlife and forests in India can be done. Answer the following questions in one sentence. Extra questions are these. You have to answer in one sentence. Okay. First question, where does it rain throughout the year? It rains throughout the year in most parts of the equatorial region. Okay. In the equatorial region, it rains throughout the year. Number two, as one moves away from the equator, does the rainfall increase? Answer, no. The rainfall decreases as one moves away from the equator. As we go away from the equator, the rainfall decreases. Okay. In the equatorial region, it receives heavy rain or it receives rain throughout the year. But when we start moving away from the equator, there is less rainfall. The rainfall decreases. Where are the evergreen forests found? Answer, evergreen forests are found in the area where it rains throughout the year. Okay. So the area where it rains throughout the year, you will get evergreen forests. What effect does rainfall have on vegetation? So because of rain, what happens? What effect is seen on vegetation? As the rainfall decreases, the density of the vegetation also decreases. Okay, where there is less rainfall, the density of the vegetation also decreases. means the vegetation growth is very less. Okay, so where its rainfall is heavy, density is more. Okay, of the vegetation. So this is the effect of rainfall on vegetation. Rainfall decreases, the density of the vegetation also decreases. Where are the largest number of vegetation species found in the world? Okay, where are the largest number of vegetation or types of plants or types of species of plants found in the world? In the world, Brazil has the largest number of vegetation species in the world. Next question, what kind of trees are found in Brazil? Examples, trees like paw Brazil, rubber, mahogany, rosewood, and a variety of orchids are found in Brazil. Why are the evergreen forests called the lungs of the world? Okay, very important question. Why are the evergreen forests are called the lungs of the world? What is the reason why it is called lungs of the world? Answer, evergreen forests are called the lungs of the world because they release large amount of oxygen in the environment. So, evergreen forest, what does they do? They release, as it is evergreen, as it is dense, okay? So, they release large amount of oxygen in the environment, which decreases the amount of carbon dioxide, okay? So, because of the release of oxygen in the environment, the amount of carbon dioxide is low. Because of this, it's because of these reasons, evergreen forests are called the lungs of the world. Ninth question, describe the leaves of trees found in evergreen forest. Now, how is the leaf? The leaves of the trees found in evergreen forest are broad and green. Next question, what is the quality of wood found in evergreen forest? The wood found in evergreen forest is hard, heavy, and durable. So these are some extra odd man out questions we will see. With question number 5, with reference to fauna in India. A. Anaconda, B. Elephant, C. Lion, and D. Tiger. So, with reference to fauna in India, with respect to animals found in India, so odd man out is A. Anaconda. Anaconda is not found over India, okay? It is odd. Next, question number 6, with reference to flora of Brazil. With respect to trees of Brazil, options A, paw Brazil, B, rubber, C, mahogany, D, deodar. So the odd one is deodar. Next, with reference to Himalayan forest, A, seasonal flowering plants, B, orchids, C, pine, D, mixed forest. So answer is odd one is orchids. With reference to birds found in Brazil, A. Condors, B. Flamingos, C. Macaws, and D. Peacocks. So odd one out is peacock. Peacocks are found in India. These were the extra odd one out. Match the column. Natural vegetation and wildlife. Okay, first, so natural, first column, evergreen forest found in option D, Western Ghats. Deciduous forest major portion of Madhya Pradesh. Okay, deciduous forest found in major portion of Madhya Pradesh. Third one, thorny shrubs. Thorny shrubs found in Gujarat. You have to match it. Fourth, Himalayan forest. Arunachal Pradesh. Coastal forest. Fifth is coastal forest found in Sundarbans. Next, match the column. First one, equatorial forest. Found in Amazon River Basin. Second, grassland forest. Found in Pampas. Third, swampy lands. Found in Pantanal. Fourth, hot deciduous forest. Found in escarpment. And fifth is thorny shrubs. Are found in Katinga. And in India, thorny shrubs are found in Gujarat. Whereas in Brazil, thorny shrubs are found in Katinga. You have to remember. We'll revise once again Brazil wildlife. Swampy areas of Pantanal, anacondas. Second, animals found in Brazil. Guinea pig, crocodiles, alligators, monkeys, pumas, leopards, etc. Varieties of fishes in sea, swordfish, varieties of fishes in rivers, pink dolphins and piranhas. Bird varieties include condors, sparrows and flamingos. A bird which is huge in size and can fly high in the sky, condors. Degradation of environment due to reasons, illegal smuggling of wild animals, slash and burn agriculture, roca, deforestation, pollution, etc. The wildlife of India. Animals found in hot and humid forests. Elephants. Elephants are found in hot and humid forests in India. Swampy and marshy lands of Assam. One horn rhinoceros in Assam, where the land is swampy and marshy. One horn rhinoceros are found. Arid lands means desert lands. Wild ass. And camels. Snow-capped region of Himalayas, snow leopards and yaks. In snowy region of Himalayas or snow-capped region of Himalayas, snow leopards and yaks are found. Peninsula region. In peninsula region, Indian bison, deer, monkeys and antelopes. These are the animals found in peninsula region. The only country in the world where both tigers and lions are found. Okay, in India, both lions also and tigers also are found. It's the only country in the world where both tigers and lions are found. Rivers, estuaries and coastal areas. Here you will find turtles, crocodiles, and gavials, that is gharial, alligator, long-nosed alligator. Variety of birds in the forest and wetlands. Here you get peacock, Indian bustard, kingfishers, pheasants, ducks, parakeets, cranes, and pigeons. In the forests of India, many species of wildlife are on the verge of extinction because of poaching, pollution, and rapid deforestation. Measures for protection of wildlife and forests in India.
setting up national parks. These are the measures for protection of wildlife. Setting up of national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, bird sanctuaries, and biosphere reserves. India vegetation, major types of forest in India: evergreen forest, deciduous types of forest, thorny shrubs, Himalayan coastal forest. We will see the leaves of trees in evergreen forest, broad and green. The type of wood of trees found in evergreen forest: hard, heavy, and durable. The quality of wood, okay, found in evergreen forest is hard, heavy, and durable. Trees having hardwood. Example of trees having hardwood, or which is heavy and durable: mahogany, rosewood, rubber. In regions, the rainfall is between 1000 mm to 2000 mm. Deciduous forest. Trees found in deciduous forest of India: teak, bamboo, banyan, peepal, etc. These are the examples of trees found in deciduous forest of India. Regions having less than 500 millimeter of rainfall: thorny shrub. Where the rainfall is less than 500, their vegetation is like thorny shrub. Types of plants found in regions having less than 500 millimeter rainfall. Okay, rainfall less than 500 millimeter. Here you get catechu, acacia, khejri, cactus, aloe vera, and agave. Swampy areas, estuaries, and lagoons. Your type of vegetation is coastal. Coastal type of vegetation is found. Coastal type of vegetation is called mangroves or sundarbans. The wood quality of coastal vegetation is oily, light, and durable. We have also seen the types of Himalayan forest according to altitude, according to height: highest altitude, seasonal flowering trees; medium altitude, coniferous trees like pine, deodar, and fir; and in the foothills, both coniferous and deciduous types of forest. Hello, ma'am. Hello. Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. We can stop here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much.